Hey guys, I'm Zoe and welcome back to my channel. Another alien movie is on the big screen, and it's been 7 years since the last alien movie came out. You know, I'm a huge fan of alien movies, particularly of which was directed by Ridley Scott. Most people see surprise attacks, screams, and kind of gross monsters in this movie franchise, but in this article, the author identified the entire metaphor of the franchise. And appealed, please stop making alien movies. So let's find out why. At the very beginning, the author illustrated the formula and narrative patterns of alien movies to make sure that everyone is on the same page. In alien movies, Xenomorph is the monstrous, all-consuming life form that exists only to make more and more copies of herself.The prefix xeno is alien and strange, and morph is gradually changed from one status to another. So xenomorph is an alternative way to say alien in this franchise. Monstrous is an adjective of a monster, but they are different. Monster is a specific, big, bad creature, while monstrous extends its meaning beyond monster.It becomes abstract. It could describe something big and bad and evil and something cruel. For example, you could say monstrous crime, 弥天大罪, or monstrous amount of money, 巨款. Something all-consuming is something taking up most of your attention or time. For example, her work is all-consuming, or cell phones have become so all-consuming.
Alien 是一种巨大的吞噬一切的生命形式，它的存在只为了复制自己。
I'm not going to expand on these plots and descriptions, but if you are curious about them, go ahead and visit my WeChat account. So in the next part, the author acknowledged the success of the latest movie. Alien Romulus is the seventh movie about these particular monsters, and it's not a bad movie. It's nicely creepy, the special effects are good, the acting is perfectly serviceable.
Serviceable 这个词特别好。它特别容易出现在一些影视剧的评论里的。
The story is serviceable, but it's not as compelling as it could be.
能看，但是没那么精彩。
Critics label the movie serviceable, but praise Blake Lively. It's not a bad film, but it's also a direct copy of a much better film that already exists. That film is called Alien, and it came out in 1979. This is the original Alien movie. Why have we spent the past 45 years...making seven different versions of the same movie.
文章开篇讲的是一些 Alien 电影的习惯的套路，他肯定了这部新的电影的观赏性，但是提出了一个质疑。为什么45年间要拍七部同样电影的不同版本呢？那下面这个解释，我觉得才是整个文章的重点。
People do like to repeat things. That is what the Alien films are actually about.The reason the 1979 original is a great movie and not just a fun monster flick is that it's really about us. Xenomorph is us.
79年的那部原作啊，它并不仅仅是一个 monster flick. Flick 可以指代 movie, chick flick, 就是女孩子爱看的那种言情电影啊。这部电影所表现出来的是，alien 其实就是人类自己。
Its alien form is just a hideous mashup of our ordinary, slimy human genitalia.This monster is your libido, a ravenous, irrational thing that wants to use your body to breed.
People mistake hideous for hidden, but hideous is way worse than hidden.
It means extremely ugly and bad. For example, Donald Trump assaulted me, but he's not alone on my list of hideous men. Or Microsoft still has time to fix the hideous start menu update.
So IT 的人都知道啊，经常会抱怨说什么什么设计太难看了。其实你可以用 hideous.
The button is hideous. 这个按钮丑爆了。
Mashup 是混合的，那在音乐界里面它可以把它认为是一个串烧。
Taylor Swift's The Eras Tour Surprise Song Mashups.
歌曲串烧。Alien 的形态只是我们普通人黏黏糊糊的人类生殖器的一种丑陋的混搭吧。
Ravenous extremely hungry. You know that growing boys have ravenous appetites.
长身体的男孩子这个胃口非常大。
Or the CEO says that being ravenous about one thing will determine if your career is a success.
对一件事情保持贪婪。那作者认为呢 ,Alien 这个形象其实是人类的性欲的体现吧。贪婪的非理性的想要用身体去繁殖的欲望。
The whole thing is about the horror of pregnancy, of childbirth, of sexuality in general, our human compulsion to procreate and endlessly repeat ourselves. That's why these films always need an android, clinically asexual, standing outside the whole messy business so you can see it more clearly. I admire his purity, says an android in the first Alien. Compulsion 是一种冲动啊，形容词用的比较多啊 ,compulsive, say compulsive purchase, 冲动购买。我们平时所说的那个强迫症 ,OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder.Alien 的这种生殖方式表现的是怀孕生产和性的恐怖，就是人们对于繁殖的强迫性，要无止境的复制自己。这个系列的每一部电影里都会有一个机器人，它是无性的。There is a famous line from the android in the original movie, that is, I admire its purity. It refers to the aliens. Over the past 45 years, the Alien franchise trusts us less and less to notice these obvious themes for ourselves.The latest one really bonks you over the head with it by putting an actual pregnant woman on board the ship. There is a final act that essentially dispenses with the entire metaphor that sustained the franchise for so long.
在过去的45年间的 Alien 的电影、越来越少的让我们注意到了这个非常明显的关于我人类自己的主题。那么最近的这一部
Bonk you with the head with it,
打到你的头了。他把真正的孕妇放到了船上。Dispense with is to get rid of.去除了摒弃了
Let's dispense with the formalities and get down to business.
啊，我们省去这些繁文缛节，然后直奔主题。
最新的电影的最后场景去除了整个系列中的一个象征性的东西，也就是刚才所说到的人类无节制的繁殖和重复的主题。
The following sentence is tricky. Can you make a guess on whether it is a plot in the movie or it is hypothetical? Our heroes might as well turn to the camera and say,Childbirth is pretty creepy, huh? Procreation, weird, am I right? It is a terrible ending, but it gives me hope. When the franchise exhausts its own central metaphor like this, surely it can limp on for much longer. Please, please, let this one be the last.
As far as I concern, it is hypothetical because of this phrase, might as well.
你不妨怎样 is to make a hypothetical suggestion. For example, if you live to 100, you might as well be happy.
如果你活到了100岁，你不妨开开心心的。
Now you're here, you might as well stay. 你不如待一待。
这部电影的现有情节是抛弃了核心隐喻，而文章的作者呢提了一个建议，你不妨让这个结尾是主角对着镜头说生孩子是个非常吓人的事情。
如果影片是以这样的结尾的话，还会给作者一些希望。所以呢，这里面最重要的一个结论出来了，当一个系列电影已经耗尽了它的中心的隐喻的时候，它其实没有办法更长时间的Limp on.
Limp 是腿瘸对吗
The limp on is walk slowly with difficulty, 步履蹒跚的 For example, Austrian ruling coalition will limp on after clash over EU natural law.
与欧盟的自然法发生冲突之后奥地利的执政联盟将步履蹒跚 And that's the reason why the author appealed to stop doing another alien movie.
So have you ever seen any of these alien movies? And which one is your favorite?Please tell me in the comment section. And I'm Zoe, and I'll see you next time.